Hello, I'm Jono from Journey with Jono. Now, normally I am featuring the fit out of my boat whilst travelling around the British waterways. But this is the first in a series of episodes from Romania. Now, a number of Victron engineers have been busy installing a whole range of applications in a VW van. Now, the van requires a reliable power supply, and that could be from the van's alternator or the mains national grid. But in this episode, they are installing solar. This is a Volkswagen Caravelle T5, and today two Victron engineers are going to start installing a lot of equipment in it to transform it into a power-producing energy machine. The van has a typical boot area. After cutting a piece of aluminium checker plate sheeting, the guys then used the rear seat's frame to build a support bracket to mount the sheet on. This gave the install a solid and strong platform to work from. We didn't want any equipment flying around the van should there be some strong braking. This aluminium sheet was drilled and riveted to mount the kit. In this episode, we'll be detailing the solar equipment used in the install. You may notice other items also being installed, but worry not, all the items shown will be featured in future episodes. This van is to be fitted with four flexible solar panels on its roof. They're installing four 100 watt panels and two solar controllers, so each controller will be fed by two panels, which are wired in series. The van arrived pretty clean, but the roof is given another thorough clean with a degreaser to remove any debris. The engineers wanted to try and fit the panels without the need to drill through the roof, as this could create leaks in the future. The panels were positioned on the roof where they made maximum contact. They used a flexible all-weather adhesive, and once stuck, they used a suitable heavy item to add a bit of pressure until the glue set overnight. The panel's cables were routed to the rear of the van and down through a rubber boot that was previously used for the rear door's electrics. The double insulated cables were then routed within the side beam into the boot area. Two of the largest items, an isolation transformer and a multi-plus compact, were fitted to the panel first. This gave us all a good idea where to place other items. You'll notice the aluminium sheet was cut out slightly to the bottom left. This was to fit the lithium battery up against the rear seat mount, again giving a solid structure to fit equipment to. Two 100 volt 20 amp smart solar charge controllers were then fitted. Where the cables passed through the aluminium panel, a plastic grommet was made and used to protect the cable against chafing whilst the van was moving. This van install will include one 200 amp hour Victron lithium battery, so it's important to protect it. They need to be protected against both over and under voltages. To do this, we used a Victron BP100 Battery Protect. The Battery Protect was programmed to its relay mode, and the charge sources from both solar controllers were wired to the M8 terminal labelled Battery on the Battery Protect. A cable was then connected to the second M8 terminal to the positive bus bar, which, after fusing, is connected to the battery. We shall go into detail about the bus bar enclosure in a future episode.
I'm the sales manager responsible for East European countries. And the whole idea with this van was to somehow show the customers all or almost all the possibilities that we have with our equipment without asking them to come and visit us. So we are going to visit different customers or different distributors, and we will show them what is possible to do with this kind of products.
Even inside the garage, the panels had enough light to start up. We installed the Victron Connect app on our phone and searched for all the available items. Both controllers were shown in the device list. We clicked on each controller and were informed about a software update. We then selected the update button within the app. Before the update started, and as this was the first time we connected to the controller, we needed to pair the SmartSolar to the phone. The request code, as default, is 000000. This then connected to the controller and updated it. There was just one more step we needed to take whilst within the controller software, and that was to tell the solar controller what type of batteries we're using. We clicked the cog at the top right of the screen, then clicked battery. As our system is 12 volts, we left the battery voltage at 12 volts. Under charger settings, we clicked on the drop-down option, selected select preset, scrolled down to lithium iron phosphate and selected it. We then clicked OK. This automatically preset the smart solar controller to charge using parameters suitable for lithium. We then repeated this for the second controller, and that's it. The solar was ready to keep our battery topped up with energy from the sun. In the next episode, the engineers wire in the van's alternator to charge the lithium battery when the engine is running. They also installed a buck boost to regulate the alternator's voltage, ensuring the battery has many happy years of use.